guys.
Hello everyone. My colleague Nicola, man with the dogs, got a call from the people from the village in the middle of nowhere. They found a dog who is 200 pounds, almost 100 kilograms, huge dog, neglected. He called me, asked can we bed him and fix him because he's in a bad condition. Of course, we agreed. We are going now to the grooming salon. We picked that dog. There will be Alexandra and let's go to make a transformation and he will find a home for him.
Okay, you heard how this dog came to us. She's probably Newfoundland the dog, run away from some kennel. She don't have a microchip, so we don't know who is her owner. Before I continue with talk, I would like to say that it means a lot to us if you watch this without speeding the video, because that helps us earn the funds we need to rescue and groom as many dogs as possible. It costs you nothing, but it means a lot to the dogs we managed to take care of thanks to it. So, thank you in advance. Now let's continue. The coat is neglected, matted and dirty. Today we will do our best to save as much hair as we can, but on the other hand to make the treatment as gentle as possible. I inspected the dog and noticed that it has an infection on the skin in the area under the tail and all the way to the stomach. I expected that because the skin that is covered with matted hair doesn't breathe. When we add dirtiness, it is a pretty good environment for the development of an infection. My plan is to shave it all off and later wash and dry it well and speed up the healing process of the skin. We will see if everything goes according to the plan today. Since you all liked when I talked about breeds in the previous videos, let's learn something new and interesting about the Newfoundland breed today. Before that, click like on this video and subscribe to our channel. Let's go!
Support this man. Here's the link.
Newfoundland dogs originated from the Canadian islands of Newfoundland, where they were bred by fishermen to work in the harsh and cold North Atlantic waters. Newfoundland have a strong, muscular body with a thick double coat that can be black, brown, grey or lancier, white with black markings. They are believed to be descendants of various European breeds, including Mastiffs and Portuguese water dogs.
In this moment, our three groomers are holding the dog because she's huge, right? And Alexandra is shaving her back.
her backside because there is infection and really big stuff of mats and I don't know the right names for that, but matted hair and yeah. It's hard to cooperate with this huge dog.
Newfoundlands were trained to save people from drowning because their natural swimming ability, strength and endurance made them invaluable in this role. They have been credited with saving many lives, and their heroic efforts are well documented. The famous French military leader Napoleon Bonaparte had a Newfoundland dog named Napoleon during his exile on the island of Saint Helene. Napoleon's affection for his Newfoundland is often mentioned in historical accounts. The famous American explorers Lewis and Clark took a Newfoundland dog named Seaman with them on their famous expedition to explore the western part of the United States. Seaman proved to be a valuable and loyal companion during their journey. Lord Byron, the English poet, had a beloved Newfoundland dog named Boatswain. When Boatswain died, Lord Byron had a monument built in his honor that was larger than his own, which reflects the deep bond he had with his companion. A Newfoundland dog named Rigel was one of the survivors of the tragic sinking of the Titanic in 1912. He managed to stay afloat in the icy waters and was later rescued by a lifeboat. The Newfoundland breed holds several records in the Guinness World Record, including one for the heaviest dog ever recorded. Newfoundland dogs are an official symbol of Newfoundland and Labrador, a Canadian province. Besides water rescue, Newfoundland dogs were used for various other tasks, including pulling loads, hauling fishing nets, and even working as draft animals. Newfoundland dogs have made appearances in movies and television. For example, a Newfoundland dog named Nana played the role of the Darling family's nursemaid in Disney's animated film Peter Pan. So, now that we've had some fun and learned everything, not everything, but something about the Newfoundland dog, Let's get back to our beauty. And yeah, if you like these educational details in this video, I'm pretty sure you will like the articles on our blog website petgroomhouse.com, because there you can learn a lot about grooming, dogs, cats, pet nutrition, pet behavior, dogs' hair and nails, and so on. You remember I said that I don't know if I will be able to completely solve the problem around the inflamed area? Unfortunately, I have not been able to shed the infected area completely because it hurts so much it has become aggressive. She will go to the vet. Her infection will be treated, and then, at the next grooming session, I will make it look nice. Now it doesn't have to be beautiful, it just matters that it heals. What do you think? Did we groom her good enough? We are getting close to the end, and you stay tuned to see how she is doing in her temporary home. We are actively looking for her forever home. And when we find it, we will do another grooming video and show you how she is doing in her forever home. And yeah, we named her Santa. Do you like it? If you like this video, click like button and go to our channel, because we have many more videos like this one. I'm pretty sure you will love it. Thanks for watching, and not fast forward the video. Love you all. See you next time. Bye.
Okay, she's done. I have done my best. Now she's going to a temporary home. Man with dogs finds for her temporary home. But after a few weeks, she is going to a forever home. Stay up to date to see that.
Bye.